background sing.
Oh, oh, Lord,
oh yeah.
Deliver me.
God, rescue me from myself, from my overthinking. If you're listening out there, just repeat after me if you're struggling with your past and say,
oh, oh,
let the Lord know. Just say, oh,
oh, oh,
He wants to restore your soul. Just say,
deliver me.
Hey, if my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven. Break it on down. So it is. It is so. Amen. Now when we pray, we want to end that with a declaration, a decree. So I'm speaking for all of you listening, starting here, starting now. The things that hurt you in the past won't control your future. Starting now, this is a new day. This is your exodus. You are officially released. Now sing it for me, Leandria.
This is my exodus.
Sunday service, which is a special service. It's our anniversary service, our third year anniversary. And we thank and welcome everyone who's here to worship with, celebrate with us on this day. Glory to God. We just worship the Lord. Let's all settle down, cell phones off, so we can worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Father God, we just come before you, God, and we just give you glory. We just give you honor. We just thank you for this new day. This is the day you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. You said, let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. And we praise your name, Father God, because you are worthy. You are just, you are loving, you are kind, you are greatly worthy to be praised. And we praise your name. We could never praise you enough. We thank you for the day that you have allowed us to arise this morning, oh Father God. We give you glory, we give you honor, God, because it was you who woke us up, not the alarm clock, oh Father God. You did not allow us to be on death's door, Father God. We thank you, Father God. We thank you for the breath that you have breathed into our body on this beautiful Sunday morning. We thank you for the traveling mercies. We thank you, Father God, for that you allowed us to see 3 years that we're able to celebrate. We thank you, Father God. Lord, it was no one but you, oh Father God, even though we was faced with some challenges, but Father God, you allowed us to see it. This day, oh Father God, that we can celebrate what you have done. We thank you, Father God. We thank you because you are just. So, Father God, you are loving. You are kind. You are Jehovah. You are Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Shalom. You are Jehovah Rapha, the healer, oh, Father God, because you have healed and you're still healing, oh, Father God. We thank you that your word is the true and living word, oh, Father God, that you, Father God, was the word that became flesh, oh, God. You allowed your son to die on the cross for our sins, oh, Father God, and we thank you, Father God, because if it wasn't for him who died for our sins, where would we be, oh, Father God? And we just bless and praise your holy name, because you are the one, the true and living God, oh, Father God. We give you glory, honor, and praise, oh, Father God. Lord, we thank you, God. We thank you for this program on today, God, for what you're going to do, oh, Lord, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord. We bless and praise your holy name, because there's no name above your name, oh, Father God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you for everyone who's partaking in this program on today, God. We thank you, Lord. May you bless each and every one, oh, Father God. May your Holy Spirit reign in this house, oh, Father God, that someone will leave here today changed. Oh, Father God, especially those who don't know you, God, that they will see, hear something, oh, Father God, that your Holy Spirit will resonate in their soul and convict their hearts, oh, God. We thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do. And we bless your name and we give you glory, honor, and praise. And Lord, Heavenly Father, amen. We're going to have a prayer, opening prayer today from our very own Reverend Lorenzo Glover.
Amen, amen. Thank you, wifey. Amen, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, saints of God. Hallelujah. Let us praise God this morning. This is the house of God. Stand to your feet and praise the Lord this morning. He deserves your honor. He deserves your glory. He deserves your praise this morning. Give it to him. This is another day of life that you have. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord this morning. Amen, amen, amen. Welcome each and every one of you this morning. May God continue to richly bless each and every one of you. Let us look to the Lord. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we come before your precious throne, we first and foremost, we give you honor. We give you praise for who you are in our lives. We ask your forgiveness of our sins because we're all sinners before you, Lord, and we recognize this. We ask that you rain down your forgiving power upon us in the name of Jesus. Now, Lord, as we lay our cares at your altar, Lord God, we ask that you speak life, that you speak victory over them, Lord. Lord God, we know that there are folks who are ailing in their bodies. We ask that you take away aches and pains that they may be experiencing. Lord God, there are folks who have lost loved ones, Lord. We ask that you bring comfort, that you bring understanding in their lives, Lord. Lord God, there's someone who has lost their job, Lord. We ask that you replace it. You open doors for them, Lord. You make a way for them. Lord God, we ask that you bless those, Lord God, who are in trouble with the law. Lord God, that you be the judge in the courtroom, that you judge right in their favor, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God, that we can lay every care at your altar, Lord. Lord God, and know that you hear us and that you answer us. So we thank you for that fact and that fact alone. Lord God, we ask that you reach across the nations. Lord God, that you bring about peace. That you calm hearts, Lord God. That you stop the wars that are going on. Lord God, touch leaders. Lord God, who affect nations. Hallelujah. Lord God, we know that you're the King of Kings. You're the Lord of Lords, Lord. Lord God, you can fix any situation. There's nothing too hard for you. Amen. Lord God, I ask that you bring about peace on our streets. Lord God, that they would see brothers and sisters, Lord God, who look to you, who look for love, Lord God, who speak love. Hallelujah. We give it to you, Heavenly Father, and we thank you, Lord God, for your presence this day, this hour, Heavenly Father. Lord God, we ask that you touch our speaker on today, Lord. Lord God, you give her that rhema word, hallelujah. that would resonate in the souls of everyone who hears it, whether here in the house, of those who are joining us online. We ask that you make her that conduit to touch hearts, to change hearts, to change minds, Lord God, to restore lives. Lord God, we just thank you for being God and God alone in our lives. And Lord God, we'll be ever so careful to give you the honor, to give you the praise that you so rightly deserve. For it's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen, 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 and amen. Amen, amen. Amen,
amen.
Amen,
amen. Thank you, Reverend Glover, for that prayer. We're going to have our scripture reading for today. It's coming from Exodus 18, 14 to 23.
Man, I'm going to ask everyone who can stand if they would stand as we read the mighty word of God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And we'll be reading from the New King James Version, Exodus 18, verses 14 through 23. Once again, Exodus 18, verses 14 through 23. And it begins, it says, "So when Moses' father-in-law saw all that he had did for the people, he said, 'What is the thing that you are doing for the people? Why do you alone sit and all the people stand before you for morning and evening?' And Moses said to his father-in-law, 'Because the people come to me to inquire of God. When they have a difficulty, they come to me, and I judge between one and another, and I make known the statutes of God and his laws.'"
Amen.
"So Moses' father-in-law said to him, 'The things that you do is not good. Both you and those people who are with you will surely wear yourselves out. For this thing is too much for you. You are not able to perform it by yourself. Listen now to my voice. I will give you counsel, and God will be with you. Stand before God for the people, so that may bring the difficulties to God. And you shall teach them the statutes and laws, and show them the way in which they must walk and the work they must do. Moreover, you shall select from all the people the men such as fear God, men who truth-hating covetousness, and place such over them to be rulers of thousands, rulers of hundreds, rulers of fifties, and rulers of tens. And let them judge the people at all times. Then it will be that every great matter they shall bring to you, but every small matter they themselves shall judge. So it will be easier for you, for they will bear the burden with you. If you do these things and God so command you, then you will be able to endure, and all the people will also go to their place in peace." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word, and may it be sanctified into the hearts of the saints who hear it. Amen?
Amen.
You may be seated in the presence of God.
Amen. Now we're going to have our announcements and our welcoming from our very own First Lady, Monique.
Amen.
I didn't want to sit down, so
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today on this auspicious day for us, our third anniversary, as you know. We are just grateful for everyone that's in the room. We want to thank our very own Pastor Lindsay for coming. She's the one that gave us our start. For her family and the rest of the folks that are here from her church, just thank you for visiting with us today. Thank you for everyone that has come out today to share in our occasion today. We do have some brief announcements. I lost my glasses, so bear with me. Bible study is every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Our very own pastor, my husband, Thaddeus Taylor, is our instructor for this Bible study coming up on Tuesday. We are in the book of Acts. We heard it in Sunday school. We're studying Acts. I can't tell you enough how much I've learned so far, just kind of revisiting Acts and learning about the early church. And just if you don't have anything to do Tuesday at 7 o'clock, or if you do have something to do, don't do it. Come and join us for our Bible study. We are on Facebook Live, and we are doing it through Zoom. Our ID for our meeting is 859-9203-7464. You can also dial in at 301-715-8592. Ladies, this Saturday, we are sold out, by the way. May 4th is our first CCWC Women's Ministry Luncheon. I'm not asking you to hold the date, I'm just telling you, because it's here. And today, actually, Pastor Lindsay is kicking off a week of fasting and prayer for us as we lead into May the 4th, our pre-Mother's Day luncheon. So ladies, it's gonna be a good time. We are gonna have four speakers, our flyer says two, but we've got four wonderful ladies coming to give us information on our mind, body, and our soul. Because as women, we do so much. Okay, ladies? Can I get a shout out for that? Okay. So just come out and hear what God says about you, hear their testimonies and how they deal with their resilience, how they juggle life in general, family, work, children, especially children, you know, for the mothers that are in the house, we know that's a job in itself. And come out and see what God says and how you should operate, what you need to do, how you need to pray, who you need to talk to, who's in your circle, all those things as to how we get influenced in our life. So just come out so we can talk about it. And our health. We're going to talk about heart health. It's here, ladies. Not just having God in our heart, we got to take care of that heart. So we need to know what we need to do for that, so that we can be all things that Christ has empowered us to be. So we do have those four powerful women of God just speaking on those various topics. Celebration Christian Worship Center is scheduled to have their first baptism, tentatively scheduled on Saturday, May the 25th, 2024 at 3 p.m. at the Mount Lebanon Baptist Church, 2914 Diamond Street. All candidates on their profession of faith will meet with Pastor Thaddeus Taylor on Sunday, May the 19th at 10:30 a.m., during Sunday school. Failure to attend will result in your not being baptized, so please attend a meeting if you plan to be baptized. Any questions, please contact our pastor. Please hold the date, June 20th, folks. We're gonna do a community event right out here at Wyalusing Park, okay? Each one, reach one, teach one. The flyer is in the program. You can look at that for details. We plan to have a good day that day with some giveaways, some people that are coming out to talk to the community. Just come together as a community, as we reach one. Sunday, September 1st, it's a big day for our very own assistant pastor, Lorenzo Glover, and my lovely sister, Deacon Ann Glover. They are going to be installed as the pastor and first lady of our church. So let's give them a hand. As we lead into September, please keep them in prayer. The installation is going to be at the Triumph Baptist Church located at 1648 West Honey Park Avenue. Hebrews 10:25 tells us, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. We do continue to ask for your special prayers for our pastor, my husband. You can see he is back. I say it every Sunday, he's back. When I tell you, yes, there is a testimony and a story, and I'm sure he'll share a little bit of that when he gives his remarks, but just praise God for healing, okay, and recovery. Still a recovery going on, but it's nothing like it was, so thank him. Holy Communion is the first Sunday each month. We do celebrate birthdays on the second Sunday of each month. Anybody with an April birthday in the house, raise your hand. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Anila. Happy blessed birthday. It's coming up. And every third Sunday is Youth Sunday. So we did have a nice service on last Sunday. Missions Focus Sunday is the fifth Sunday of each month. Our church's missions efforts in the community, especially concerning youth and families, is what we ask you to pray for. Please continue to pray for the sick among us and those that are grieving the passing of loved ones. Pray for our church leaders and the membership that we continue to grow, that we bring on those people that want to serve God in every way. And please continue to pray for just the world in general. Right now is just not a good place. So please continue to pray. The Celebration Christian Worship Center's focus is on three homes: a stronger home where you live, a supportive church home, a spiritual heavenly home eternally through faith in Jesus Christ. And I do want to take a minute and just read a thank you card. We had a group in here yesterday called the Hope Ministries. When I came in here yesterday to, you know, help them shut things down, man, this room was so spirit-filled. I will tell you, they were up here praising God, truly praising Him. They sent us a thank you card saying, "Dear Celebration Christian Worship Center, thank you from the top, middle, and bottom of our heart for allowing us to use your space. Your church has truly blessed the whole Message Club family, and thank you for everything." Their venue got canceled at the last minute, and they were trying to find somewhere to have their anniversary celebration. So we were able to bless them, and we're just thankful that we were able to do that. Again, welcome today, and thank you. God bless you.
Amen. Let's say amen.
Amen.
Yeah, let's give God a hand. Y'all was kind of weak. Now, if I was Stevie Wonder, you would be really clapping. But I'm not, so I guess that's why you're not. But in any case, we give honor to God and to the ministers who are here, to the officers and members, to the initiating worship leader, Deacon Glover, to Reverend Glover, who's going to take over after this. Just to everyone that's here, we bring you greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. What I'm looking forward to, as you can see, I'm in my wheelchair, but in about 2-3 weeks, I'll be walking. Amen. We're on schedule to receive our prosthetic limb, and then we'll be walking and got to go through training with that and whatever. But I thank God. Amen.
Amen.
God, I thank Him. I do. Yeah, I do have a story, and I'm not going to tell it all because, as my grandfather, who pastored for many years, said, you can't tell it all in one night. So I won't try. But I will say this. I know God has brought me from a mighty long way. I know that. There's just no doubt. I just found out, and this happened 2 months ago, that I was on a ventilator for almost, 5 days. And I didn't know. They were keeping me alive because I kept flatlining and they told me I died 5 times. And I was like, I died five times. I didn't know I died one time. They said, no, for those four or five days, I had passed away, and they kept bringing me back five. They happened five times. Every time I go to see my doctor, they remind me of that. Oh, yeah, it's good to see you. You know you died five. I'm like, look, don't tell me this story no more. I don't want to hear it, but I give God the glory. It gave me an opportunity, both in the hospitals that I was in, to tell people about Jesus. I mean, just anybody you meet who met me in any of the hospitals will tell you that I shared my testimony. Because if God's going to keep doing that, and I had made provisions just in case I didn't come back. I didn't know I wasn't going to come back, but just in case what to do. But the Lord kept bringing me back. I mean, there comes a point where after a few of those that you figure you're done. And so they kept joking with me, like, did you use any lives before now? Because we don't want to use all nine of them up. But I will say this, and it really is true. And people have asked me, did you see a light and all that? I will just say this. No, I didn't. But I did see God talking to me. That's why I didn't know I was dead, because the whole time, and I didn't know it was 5 days, God was talking to me the whole time. And it was an amazing thing to experience the reality of God talking to you like that. And it was so, I learned about him something that you read about it, but you don't understand it. That God is a very personal person. That when he's bringing you along, he's not pushing you along. He's talking to you. And through his messengers, through his word, God is talking to you, but you got to be convinced of what he's saying. Amen. Like, well, you know, we like to make up what we can do. Like, what we can do, he don't have nothing to do with it. You know, like, we can do what we want. God's sitting on the sideline, kicked to the curb or something. That is not how he operates. But I will say this, and this is really true, and I'm going to confess on myself. The whole time God's telling me what to do when I come out of wherever I was, I kept saying, I don't want to do it. I kept saying, I need you to, you know, I could tell you what he said exactly. I need you to say X, Y, Z. I won't get into the details. And I kept saying no. I kept saying no. I didn't know I was dead. It was like if I kept saying no, I might not have been. But I kept saying no because I had a plan for my life. Oh, y'all don't hear me today. I had a plan for my life that was not his. Do you hear me? We plan our lives as if we can plan it. And all it takes is something out of the blue to change all our thinking, and we get depressed and we get frustrated and all of this because we think we can control our own lives. And God wants you to know you don't. But God is not a bully. God is not going to force you, but he can convince you. So for those days, and I'm going to say this because I thank God I'm in the third anniversary of a church where we are, by the grace of God, going to make some strides. But I believe to this day I was under for that many days, and I kept dying that many times, and he kept bringing me back that many times until finally, and I'll never forget when I finally said, okay, Lord, you keep telling me I got to do this. What do you want me to do? That's when I came out of it. And I'm going to tell you, it is as real. Y'all know, anybody know me? No, I don't make up stuff like that. That's just too spooky for me. But it was as real. And then I woke up and there were people in my room who I didn't know were there and stuff hanging out of me everywhere. Because the ventilator was there, and the thing in my neck, and the things in my arm, and all that. And I'm like, and so the first thing, I think it was my wife, who said, "You a miracle, because you know you died five times." And we laugh about it, because I kept saying, "Why did you bring me back?" But the Lord brought me back for a reason. And now that I got that testimony out, and it's been hard to get out. I cannot explain to you the difficulties I had in my own. When I tell you that God can expose you in ways that you cannot fathom, and will talk to you about things about you that only you know, and He knows. And so when you start talking to God about stuff, He will tell you stuff about you, and you know, in fact, He said to me, "You know it's true." And I had to say, "Yes, I do know." And we're going back and forth like that. So the point I'm making to you is this, that God is real. I could truly say that life after this is real, because I experienced something that's very much that way. And that we really need to surrender. And so God said, when you come back, I want you to tell people what you know and be my witness. So with that being said, I'm here. We're celebrating our third anniversary. I want to thank all of our members who are not only here now, but have come and gone over the course of those 3 years. You have all been a blessing to me, but I promise you, not only are we moving forward and Reverend Glover and the things that we're doing, but as I've promised, I will be the best member of this church that he could possibly have in doing the work here. Because the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. And the world is such that they've scared us out of being laborers for God, because that means we might get shot somewhere doing something for the Lord. But I'd rather die for his sake than to die goofing around out here like some of us are doing. So anyway, pray for me and my wife. Pray really for my wife. My wife, if she didn't love me, and I know she does, but if she didn't love me, she would not be doing what she's doing, because I literally came from nowhere physically. I couldn't raise a foot. I couldn't raise a leg. I couldn't raise my arm. I couldn't do anything. I was alive, but I couldn't do anything. And so for her to step in after they got me to the point I could come home, and for her to step in and begin to do the things that she's done, to the point where most everything now I'm doing it myself, but she still has to help me with a lot. You need to thank God for her and pray for her. Don't be faking, and you know you helped. Yeah, I know Jesus, because trust me, I know the devil is your husband. But anyway, God bless each of you. The announcements were given. They are so important. The women sold out. There's somewhere around 50 so far, close to 50 women that have signed up for this coming Saturday. And so we thank God for that. We're working toward the summer activity on June the 20th. And Reverend Glover, if you could just name when you get up some of the organizations that are participating. We got hospitals, we got government. He'll tell you some of who they are. But there was a, years ago, there was a saying that you plan great things for God, and you expect great things from God. And we are planning great things for God, and we are expecting great things from God. God bless you. Thank you all for coming. Anila, girl, you are growing up so fast. Lord Jesus, we are just happy to see you here. As we are so many of us, I'm not going to get into no name calling, but y'all don't mind me calling out a young person, right? Amen. You oldsters, he ain't calling my name. You know your name. She knows hers too, but I just had to do that. And our young people are participating. Here they are. Amen. They're going to be singing. I'm just excited. It's our anniversary. 3 years, blood, sweat, and tears, but God has blessed us in a mighty way. More announcements of things happening that you don't know about yet to come.
Amen, saints. Amen. So I just want to add to some of the things that Pastor said. First and foremost, believe me, God is not through with you yet. You are First Lady. So that's why, you know, you're still here with us. Amen. You know, your guiding hand. Amen? Amen. Amen. Next, as far as the community event is concerned, I'm so excited about it. June the 20th, it's going to take place. Some of the organizations that we have coming out, we have Temple University Hospital, who's participating, and some healthcare, you know, to give to the community. Also, I'm speaking with University of Pennsylvania. Also, who else is helping out? ShopRite, Target. And a couple of others. The young lady is going to be out here with the expungement program. Why Not Prosper is going to be out here with their resource bus, handing out, you know, things to the community. So I'm so excited. We're going to have food. We're going to have fun. We're going to have speakers. We're going to have a prayer station out there as well, because we have to make our presence known to the folks in our community. Amen. Amen. So please, please do join us on that date. And also, I always forget to mention, we need volunteers. If you have the time off, you can help us set up, tear down, break it down. Would be great. We're starting, start time is 12 noon that specific day. All right, so we will probably need you out there probably about 10:30. Or 11 at the latest, you know, to help us out. If you can lend us a hand, please, please, please do join us. Amen? Amen. The next thing I would like to say, I have a date, and I'm so excited about this date. We have our Word on the Street ministry. We usually throw our Word on the Street ministry as soon as the weather breaks and it's nice out. We're up on 52nd and Market Streets on Saturdays. And I'll have a calendar of the dates that we have for each Saturday that we're out there ministering to folks, praying for folks, sharing the word of God, handing out tracts, just to encourage folks. Amen? Amen. So please join us on that. Our first date will be May the 11th. May the 11th. So please, please, those of you who normally come out to support the ministry, Word on the Street ministry, we're going to be up on 52nd Street at 11 a.m. That's when we start our ministry. And you'll hear a word while we're up there, too, because we usually ask a guest speaker to come out and give a word for about 20, 25 minutes also as we're out there. So please, please do join us out there. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Right now, we're going to have our Celebration Youth Ensemble come up and give us a selection. Let us receive them.
He's got the whole world in his hands. the whole world in his hands. He got the United Brother in his hands. He's got the United Brother in his hands. He's got the United Brother in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. Whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world here. In his hands, he's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
Amen.
Amen, amen. Let's continue our worship. If you have your Bibles with you, please turn to me to Luke 21, verses 1 through 4. Luke 21, verses 1 through 4. And it reads, Jesus looked up and saw the rich putting in their gifts into the offering box. And he saw a poor widow putting in two small copper coins. And he said, truly, I tell you, this poor widow put in more than all of them. For they contribute out of their abundance, but she out of her poverty put in more in all that she had to live on. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. Amen. This is our offering time.
Amen.
Amen. And it's worship. This is part of worship. Amen. And as we begin our offering, I'd like to explain our giving envelopes, because we have several giving envelopes. Our first giving envelope is our blue and white envelope, which is for our general tithes and offering. If you don't have one, just raise your hand and we can get one to you. Next is our pastor's love offering envelope, which is our brown and beige envelope. Our pastor does not receive a salary from the church, but live off of the offerings that we give to him. And, you know, if you appreciate your pastor and he's always there for you, praying for you, guiding us through God's word, show him that we appreciate him. Amen? And next is our last offering envelope, which is our white envelope. This is for our speaker. We like to honor our speakers that come out and give a word, because we recognize the study time that it takes to deliver God's word to God's people. Amen? So we just want to show them honor too as well. Amen?
Amen,
amen, amen. Amen. So if you need an envelope, please raise your hand and we'll get one to you. And also, for those of you who are online, who are joining us online, we have a way that you can give to this ministry as well. We have a Cash App address. And our Cash App address is $CCWC21. Once again, $CCWC21. And we will accept any denomination that you have to give. We'll appreciate it. It'll be used for ministry efforts in and outside our community. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let us get some giving music, Brother Sam. As we hallelujah, hallelujah, my burdens down.
before you do the prayer, I want to say Brother Melvin was in the hospital this week.
Yes, he was.
Amen. And for a couple days, and got out, and is here today. So we ought to thank God. Thank God for him.
All right. For those of you who can stand, please stand as we pray over the offering. Amen. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we just thank you. We bless you and we honor you, Lord God, that we can give back to you what you've given unto us. Lord God, we pray over these offerings, these finances, Lord God, that it would be used for the building of your kingdom. Lord God, we ask that you bless those who aren't able to give at this time, that they would be able to participate with us next time. And Lord God, we honor you, we bless you, and we praise you, for it's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Right now, before we have our special presentation with Anila, amen. We're going to ask Brother Sam. He has a testimony that he would like to share. Amen?
Amen. I praise the Lord. I just had to eulogize my daughter in Georgia. I think for the prayers and the support of celebration, I can feel y'all prayers. A lot of time when you're going through something, you know, you can feel the prayers of the saints. Amen?
Amen.
And I was just, the thing that really bothered me is when you go to a funeral and the preacher say, I didn't know John, but I heard. You know, we should have a relationship in the house of God and with the people of God where they can say, well, I know. I went to a service and the preacher got up and he was talking about the deceased. And he said, he's a wonderful Christian, wonderful man of God. He was a good husband, a faithful husband, supporter of the church. And I was sitting and I was looking at the wife when he was saying this, because I knew the brother personally. And I seen the wife kind of raised up a little bit to see was she in the right service. Amen. So you want to live a life, amen, that's pleasing to the Lord. But I thank God that I know that she went to heaven and I, because I personally, about 5 years ago, led her to the Lord.
Amen.
So again, I thank y'all for your support,
amen,
and I thank you for your prayer. Amen. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Before Sister Anila comes up, I just want to, you know, thank God for her and her willingness to come out and celebrate at our third anniversary. Because I remember her growing up and performing praise dance with her grandmother, you know, who she's here in her stead, you know, because Minister Perlman could not make it. She made sure that we had her daughter, a granddaughter, come out and, you know, perform a nice praise dance. So, Anila, with no further ado, I'm going to ask you to come up and share your praise.
I heard him say, he brought me from a mighty long way. Say, you brought me from a mighty long way, and now today I can testify that I believe it. And on my way, I realize he's the one who kept me when the storms of life nights and desperate cries. He has captured every tear, assuring me he hears every prayer, waiting on the answer, only to discover he is near, and he hears every prayer. For he has done great things, and I believe he's a God that always answers prayer.
Give her a hand. Let us give all our youth a hand, amen? Because they did a wonderful job. And it's hard for adults to get up in front of folks and speak and sing, especially when it comes to praising our God.
Amen.
Let's encourage them to continue to do so. We praise them when they're out there in the world, you know, when they're singing, when they're playing sports. Let's praise them. Let's give them honor for praising our Lord and our Savior. Amen? Amen. I'm going to turn the mic over to Pastor as he introduced our speaker of the hour. Amen?
Amen. Amen. And the adult choir, you're coming up before. Amen. I'm just making sure. I get to introduce Pastor Lindsay Ward. We met long before, actually, we began ministering at their church. And I'm trying to think of who, someone introduced us. But anyway, it was like we hit it off in terms of ministry. But the greatest thing out of all the stuff we did, because I did some financial literacy, if I could recall, financial literacy and education programs, which I'm certified to do over there. And then there were just other things that we just kind of collaborated and did. And then when the Lord laid on our hearts to form, because I'm not the founder, or I'd say organized Celebration Christian Worship Center, she was the most gracious. You know, some people you can't sit down and work out anything. Amen, lights. I'm gonna say that. You can. I mean, you can. I mean, there some people is just so hard-hearted. You know, we forget that we had to be forgiven too. Amen. And we come off, I don't know how, but anyway, Pastor Lindsay was gracious because we didn't have anything. Amen. We didn't have any members, really. It was only like, a handful of us. Some of them are here today. Amen. Some of them are not. I have here Reverend Sam. I have here Melvin Burton. I have Maxine Slappy back there. My wife, myself, Minister Lynn was with us at the time, and Deacon Prillerman, he was not a member, but he was there every week, so he might as well have been. And Linda, who's gone on to be with the Lord, who's not with us anymore. That was the core of our church. That was it. I didn't split a church, you know. People like, where are you going? Where are you going? No, I'm not trying to split any church. Amen. Because that's not the job of the ministry. There's enough, as my pastors say, enough sinners out here for all of us. So we got to do it that way. So the fact is that she worked out a formula with me that enabled us to pay rent. Amen. We didn't ask for freebie. I don't think we ever did. We paid a little something, but it was might as well have been free, really. But I ain't trying to tell on you. But anyway, we paid rent, and it escalated every month until we reached a certain level. Then we paid the same over an extended period, and it escalated, till it got to the point where, as we began to grow and we began to want to do more ministry, as you heard, we had ministry here yesterday. We have other things that are being planned, other things that have been done. We needed a place that we could utilize more than one day a week. And God graciously enabled us to come here to be at this building. Now, she is a dynamic human being, and she will tell you that I wasn't easy on her. So therefore, it wasn't like, you know, she was late, you know. Anybody know me with lateness, know you got a problem. So I used to tell her, because I'd be waiting and she wouldn't show, I'd leave and she'd get there and I'd be gone. And this is, but we never stopped being friends. Do you understand what I'm saying? See, some people, a little something, that's it for you. You know, we never stopped being friends. Never to this day. I believed in my heart, I owed it to her, for her to come be with us
to share in this third anniversary, the first one we've really had here in this facility. And for her to, because she's had me preach at her church and conduct services and all that, and I ain't never heard her preach yet. And she was like, you know, I don't know. I would say to her, when am I going to hear you? But so now I'm going to hear her for the first time. Amen. And those who know her ought to be given a hearty amen. Now, our adult choir will sing. And the next voice you will hear will be that of Pastor Doretha Lindsay Ward. We did a brief, we copied a write-up from CBF that they did of Women in Ministry of her. We put some of that in the program. We're not going to read it to you, but you can read it on your own time, of just how she came along. I didn't know she was Virginian. I didn't know a whole bunch of stuff till I read that whole article. But I thank God for her, because she do have that Southern kind of flair to her anyway. So after the choir comes, the ensemble rather, the next voice you'll hear will be that of Pastor Lindsay Ward.
Amen. 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 Come on.
Come on, ensemble.
First Lady, amen.
Amen.
It is truly an honor to be here in the presence of the Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It is an honor to be a part of your third year celebration. Amen. And I thank God that you...
Is that one off?
Yeah, it's off.
I thank God that you...
No, it's not. No, because when she turned it in, it now it is.
Okay. Amen. Praise the Lord. I thank God for this opportunity. I do not take it lightly when God opens a door for me to give the word. Amen. And a pastor was talking, and I was thinking to myself, don't tell it all, Pastor, but... One time, Pastor and I had a meeting. Pastor was working for TD Bank.
TD Bank, yes.
TD Bank. And I was probably 10 minutes late. And yes, that's right. And I got there, and I said, Pastor, did I miss you? He said, oh, I was there already. I was and I'm not coming back. I'm like, okay. Amen. But as he said, through it all.
Yes.
You know, when God puts you together,
yes.
You
yes.
know, God has a reason and a purpose
yes.
for everything yes. that he does.
Yes,
yes
he does.
Yes, he does. You know. So little did we know that us meeting, God had a bigger purpose and plan for you. Amen. And I was to play a small part of that plan. Amen. So we thank God. We're excited about being here on today, assisting you in celebrating your third year. Amen. And I pray that God will bless you. Amen. To have many, many more. Amen. Let us look to the Lord. God, we realize that the fulfillment of the promise depends on our waiting. We thank you, Lord, that you filled us with your Holy Spirit. So since you filled us with your Holy Spirit, please allow us to rest our expectations on your promise while we pray and wait on your fulfillment. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, God. I want to thank God for Reverend Washington. Amen. Digger Washington. Amen. 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 They are always ready to support. Amen. Amen. For Sister Tanya. Amen. For Sister Melinda. Amen. Amen. And for her baby who's hiding her eyes. Amen. Thank you for coming out and supporting your pastor. Amen. We read the scripture already, and I don't plan before you long, but I plan to stand here until God tell me to sit
there.
There
you go.
Amen.
That's what you do.
Amen. In the book of Exodus, the 18th chapter, starting at verse 14, amen. And Pastor read it already, but if you will bear with me, I would like to read it again. So when Moses, father-in-law, saw all that he did for the people, he said, "What is this thing that you are doing for the people? Why do you alone sit and all the people stand before you from morning until evening?" And Moses said to his father-in-law, "Because the people come to me to inquire of God." And when they have a difficulty, they come to me, I judge between one another, and I make known the statutes of God and his laws. So Moses, father-in-law, said to him, the thing that you do is not good. Both you and the people who are with you will surely wear yourselves out. For this thing is too much for you, and you are not able to perform it by yourself. Listen now to my voice. I will give you counsel, and God will be with you. Stand before God for the people so that you may bring the difficulties to God. I'm going to say it again. Stand before God for the people so that you may bring the difficulties to God. And you may teach them the statutes and the laws and show them the ways in which they must walk and work. They must do. Moreover, you shall select from all the people able men, such as fear God, men of truth, having covetousness, and place such over them to be rulers of thousands, rulers of hundreds, rulers of fifties, and rulers of tens. And let them judge the people at all times. Then it will be that every great matter they shall bring to you, but every small matter they themselves shall judge. So it will be easier for you, for they will bear the burden with you. And if you do this thing, and God so command you, then you will be able to endure, and all the people will also go to their place in peace. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
And I took for a topic, amen. Verse 18 says, both you and these people who are with you will surely wear yourselves out. For this thing is too much for you, and you are not able to perform it by yourself.
Amen.
Amen. So I want to talk to you just for a few minutes. Can you help me, please?
Amen. There you go.
Can you help me, please? Saints, no one person can do it all.
No.
No.
Ministry is too big for one person to do it all by themselves. I will even say to you that ministry is too big for one congregation to do it all by themselves. Amen. But because I believe Pastor said earlier that there are enough sinners. Amen.
Amen.
To go around.
Amen. Yes, it is.
And isn't it interesting how you will find a church on every corner?
Amen.
Yes. Amen. But it appears that the sinners are growing and growing and growing.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So
yes.
Is it because the church is not doing what God intended for the church to do? Amen.
Amen.
We enjoy coming. Can I act like I'm in St. Peter's?
You are.
We enjoy amen, coming to church on a Sunday morning, amen. But pastor, when it's time to do outreach, amen, can I be real? Amen. Amen. You might not invite me back, but it's okay. I'm planning to retire soon anyhow. So, amen. It is interesting that we don't mind getting dressed and coming to church on a Sunday. Amen. Amen. And sitting in the chairs. But when it comes to doing the real work, when it comes to telling someone about Jesus, how he died on the cross for our sins, then we don't have time. Can I be myself, Pastor? But can I step back for a minute? And don't nobody ask me how I know. Amen. When you go to the casinos. Can I tell the truth? When you go to the casinos are full.
Go ahead. Go ahead now. Talk.
With church folk.
Yes.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
That's right.
Yes, they are.
We find a way to get to the casino.
Yes.
Well.
Lose our bill money.
Yes.
Lord have mercy.
Can I?
Lose the bill money. Go ahead now, talk.
And then tithes and offering. And then come to church talking about, Pastor, I don't have no money, I can't pay my bill. Well, I guess not. Let me stop meddling and let me.
No. Keep on preaching.
So we all know someone with the Moses syndrome. People with the Moses syndrome feel like nothing can be done right unless they do it.
Yeah.
All right.
So let me just park for a minute. Moses had a right. To feel pumped up. Amen.
Well, go ahead now.
But what Moses missed, that's why God sent his father-in-law, is that no one person can do it all.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Everybody has got to help.
Yes.
In order to make the ministry grow.
Yes.
It is simply lazy thinking on the part of the Holy Ghost-filled, Bible-carrying, toting, baptized believers to think that one individual can handle all the issues, all the problems, and all the circumstances in the church.
Well.
And I guess I shouldn't have said Bible toting because don't many folk carry Bibles no more. Amen.
Amen.
I've come to realize that church folk think that the pastor is superhuman.
Well.
I've come to realize that church folk think that God has a special treatment for how the pastor get finances to pay his bills.
Well.
Y'all gonna kick me out of here.
No, they won't kick you out. I won't.
I've come to realize, amen, that church folk think that the pastor is supposed to go and visit the sick, preach funerals, preach to the congregation on Sunday morning and raise the dead on Monday.
Lord have mercy. That's a lot.
And as soon as the pastor fell to do one thing, the congregation is ready to stone him to death.
Lord have mercy. Well.
Because they think that the pastor is not human.
Look out. Look out.
Huh. This mindset that we as church folk today that have come to believe, amen,
yeah.
It is not a good thing. Amen.
No.
It's not a good thing. And can I tell you something else? We are supposed to pay tithes and offerings.
Yes, yes, we are.
Okay, if you don't pay your tithes, pay offering.
Amen.
But I'm going somewhere with this, Pastor. Okay? Okay?
Lord Jesus, go ahead.
The tithes and the offering, I noticed that you have a special offering for your pastor. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Let me paraphrase. The Word of God says, if you give a prophet a glass of water, you get a prophet's reward.
That's what it says. Yeah.
And guess what? Yeah, that's right. You'll catch that later. But guess what? But guess what? The pastor is the last person that we want to give money to.
Amen?
Amen. But we will go. Can I talk about it?
Yeah, go ahead.
We'll go to the liquor store and we'll spend $500 a week.
Yeah. Lord, yeah. It's all right. Let him get you. Don't stop.
So, Moses' father-in-law said, the thing that you do is not good. Amen. He said, both you and these people who are with you, surely you will wear yourselves out. And for this thing is too much for you, you are not able to perform it by yourself. Amen?
Amen.
So after observing how he had been leading the people, Jethro gave Moses an alternative approach to leading them that would be more efficient and effective. God wants you to know on today, one person cannot do it all.
Amen.
Amen.
Moses did not realize that he was wearing himself out because he was busy trying to do the thing that he thought he needed to do for the people of God. But sometimes the more the pastor does, hallelujah, the less it is appreciated, amen. And the one thing about pastors wearing yourself out for the people of God is that when the people of God get ready to cast you away,
Lord have mercy,
they don't have a problem walking away. And sometimes, Pastor, you know what I've discovered? It is the people that you embrace and do the most for are the ones that will walk away.
Thank you.
Amen.
But that's all right. God's got your back.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, amen. Yes, yes. Amen.
So this new model of leadership that Jethro introduced to his son-in-law, it probably was not new, because there's nothing new under the sun.
Yes,
but
yes,
it was new to Moses. And you know, people have a tendency, amen, some have a tendency to gravitate, and then some have a tendency to avoid.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
And so,
yes,
what did Jethro tell Moses? The first thing he told him was, he said, teach the people the statutes and the laws and show them the way in which they must walk and the work they must do. Amen. God never called a pastor to do all the work in the church. He said, select from all the people able men, such as fear God, and men of truth.
Yes.
So there was a qualification,
yes,
of the persons or the men that were selected to lead the people. Amen.
Yes.
So God was saying, first of all, they have to fear me.
Yes.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And they have to, they have to have the truth.
Yeah.
They can't have the truth coming from their mouth and then walking a lie.
Yeah.
I know nobody knows anybody like that.
Yeah.
Amen.
He said,
mm-hmm, place such over to be rulers of thousands, rulers of hundreds, and rulers of fifties, and rulers of ten. Amen.
Yes, yes.
You know, the deacons and the ministers ought to be able to rule over folk in the church. Amen. And not have the folk to bring every little issue to the pastor.
Amen.
Somebody ought to be godly enough to be able to step in the gap for the pastor. Amen. He said, let them judge the people at all times. Then it will be that every great matter that they shall bring to you, but every small matter they themselves shall judge. So in other words, the scripture is saying, if you got God-fearing men,
yes,
and women,
yes,
amen,
amen,
amen, amen, but you have to have folk that have the heart of the pastor, folk that love the Lord. Amen. Because pastor in the church, you as a pastor, you're like, God, send folk in. God, send folk in. God, grow the church. And then as soon as the folk come in, folk chase them out the door.
Lord have mercy. Oh, yeah.
All right.
Mm-hmm. You talking.
In the church, amen, in the church,
amen,
we all should do our part. God have called the pastors to equip the saints, amen, and then the saints are supposed to go out and enlarge the church, amen,
yes,
amen, but the saints want the pastor to do it all. Let me hurry along here. You see, God has set members, each one of them in the body, just as he pleased.
Amen.
And if they were all one member, where would the body be?
Amen.
But now, indeed, there are many members, yet one body.
Yes.
And the eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you,
right,
nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you.
Right.
God has one body, with many members, but God only gave the body one head.
Amen.
Y'all will catch that tomorrow.
Amen. Amen. Go ahead. Go ahead.
God, through scripture, tells us that prior to the change of the leadership style, Moses literally worked all day and attempted to do everything himself without the assistance of others. That was a consuming task, not just for Moses, but for the people. Can you imagine when I was, and I'm almost done, saints, when I first started at St. Peter's, amen, the building, amen, that we now have used to be the 2-3 center, 3-2 center. And what would happen, no lie, on every day of the week, it used to be the center where welfare recipients would come and they would collect their food stamps and, you know, whatever else they get. When I tell you the line would be looped around the block, and they would stand in line, they would be there from early morning until late afternoon. Amen. That's it. So that's the visual that I got with Moses.
Right.
Folk were looped around the block, waiting for Moses to resolve their issue.
Yeah.
But if Moses had had able men,
right,
amen,
right,
some of those able men would have been able to take some of the burden away from him, amen.
Yeah.
If Moses had able men, amen, then he would not have had to wear himself out. We are to give the pastor a break.
Amen.
God has gifted all of us. Amen. So can I get some help this morning?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Can I get some help this morning?
Yeah, 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 yeah. Go ahead.
Those of you who are presently in leadership roles and you say God called you to be a leader, then step up and stop being a stumbling block in the church.
Amen. Thank you.
Can I get some help this morning?
Yes.
Someone other than the pastor must step up and say, here am I. Lord, use me for your service.
Yes.
Can I get some help this morning?
Yes.
You are being led by your pastor or leader to go to a new level in Christ. So help the pastor to grow you and stop fighting the pastor on every side. Can I get some help this morning? Stop having in-home services. Pick your body up and come to the house of God and assemble yourself with other believers in Christ. Amen. Zoom have made us lazy. Amen. As we sit in our robes, hallelujah, with a cup of coffee in our hand, and we're looking at the pastor because we're not paying attention. We're not learning anything. Amen. Can I get some help this morning?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is there someone today willing to stand up and be a leader in the community? Amen. Go out and witness for the Lord. Is there someone who's willing to talk to our young men and women and introduce them to Christ? Can I get some help this morning? I want you to know that no one can do it all. But if each of us did our own part in the church, for God has gifted each one of us. And And if I walk in my gift and you walk in your gift and you stop walking in my gift and I stop walking in your gift, amen, hallelujah, we'll be able to build the kingdom of God, amen. So we have to be able to come together, be one body in Christ. We've got to love one another. Amen. Listen. I know it don't happen in this church. Amen. But in the church, we've got to stop shouting and saying, God, I love you and hallelujah. And then as soon as church over, walk past our sister or brother and don't even.
Go ahead, mercy.
Amen.
Apostle Paul said, for me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Preach it for me, my brother.
Amen. Oh, yeah.
God has given us a challenge today, and that challenge is we cannot wear each other out, particularly the pastor. If God put you here, God put you here to be a help,
yes,
not a hindrance,
yes,
not to talk about what used to be.
Amen.
I used to be 5 years old, but I'm not five anymore.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
I used to be five. One preacher wrote, there is no victory without a battle.
Amen.
No testimony without a test.
Amen.
No miracles without an impossible circumstance.
Yes.
Amen.
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 God has called us.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
To do a work. Saints, with all that's going on around us, when we look, amen, at the news, the world is in a state of chaos.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
But I believe that we as saints, if we pray more,
amen.
If we really prayed more, if we fast more, amen, I believe that God will turn it around. Amen. He's done. Amen. He will intervene. Amen. He will intervene. Thank you, brother. You can preach this sermon for me. Amen. God is a God that will do the impossible.
That's right. That's right.
Yes, he will.
Yes, he will. Hallelujah.
He said this to you and to me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We got to get rid of the attitudes.
Yeah. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
And we got to see God for who he is.
Amen.
And when we can see God for who he is and what he can do. And the other thing is, I'm going to say this, and I'm good at St. Peter's. I'm good for five, for at least five times saying I'm going to take my seat. But I won't do that to you today. The other thing is this, amen. I often tell the saints at St. Peter's, God has given us power.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yes.
And we as saints are living beneath our privilege. Because we don't use the power that God has given us. If we tap into the power source, amen, if we truly tap into the power source, Amen. Don't you know that there is no devil in hell that would be able to have victory over our lives? Amen. If we tap into the power source, amen. Amen. There is nothing that's impossible, because the word teaches us that if you go to God and if you pray, if you ask God for something, not with a wavering mind, but believe that you're going to receive it, amen, God will give it to you. Amen. God will give it to you. But if you go to him, amen, not believing that you are worthy, then guess what's going to happen? You are not going to get it. Amen. I'm going to close for real with this. Amen. Tanya's keeping track. That's my third one, she said. I'm going to close with this. Someone sent me a video, and it was a pastor. And he was talking about Cassius Clay's daughter. She was fighting. And while she was fighting, she was losing the battle. But then, all of a sudden, she regained strength. She refocused, amen, and she began to win the battle.
Amen.
And somebody asked her, what were you thinking about when you refocused? Amen. She said, I was thinking about my father. I was thinking about those times when my father was fighting and he was almost losing the battle. But then he regained strength and he restructured himself. Amen. And he began to fight. Amen.
Amen.
I want to say to you today, who's your father?
Amen.
Who's your father? If you know who your father is, there is no battle that you can't win. Because the word says what? The battle is not yours, but it's the Lord's. And my favorite scripture is, excuse me, my favorite scripture is, don't wait until the battle's over. Ah! Shout now! Hallelujah. Shout now. Because the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Amen. God, in the name of Jesus, we come to you today and we thank you for your word, God. God, we pray that this word will penetrate in our hearts, God. God, it is time for us to do things differently. God, we have got to stop doing things the old way. We've got to stop being crabs in a barrel and understand that you are God and you set us here for a purpose.
Amen.
God, we thank you for the open door and allowing me to be a part of this great celebration. God, my prayer is that you bless this house. Dear God, that you give increase, God, that you move on your behalf, God, because, God, you know the thoughts that you have towards us, and they are thoughts of good and not of evil. This prayer we pray in your name and for your sake. Our souls say amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. That's okay. Yes.
All I can say is I missed something if I had waited this long to hear this woman preach. We're going to give the invitation because no sermon is complete without the invitation. Because it's asking you to do something, but now it's our turn to invite you
to do what we've been asking. If you don't know Christ as your Savior, we've been asking you to give him your life. And the message definitely was loud and clear. That's what you need to do if you have not already done it. Then the message also invited you that if you had already done it, but you haven't made a commitment really, and you have stepping in your relationship with God, the message also invited you to take seriously that relationship and that commitment. And all the illustrations, the scripture, all of that, it don't mean a thing if it went right over your head, in one ear, out the other ear, and it meant absolutely nothing to you if it was meant for you. If you think somebody was picking on you, remember, God was the one doing the picking. Because how could she know what we needed if she hadn't been here? God gave her the message for the people who are here and the people who are online, of which we have well over 100 and some odd people who are following us online every week. So we're reaching people. That message was for every last one of us, me included. The question is, what am I going to do with it? So here's my suggestion. If you don't know Christ and you haven't surrendered your life and you don't know him as your Savior and Lord, do it today. The Bible says now is the accepted time. Now is the day of salvation. Today, when you hear his voice, harden not your heart. You say, what do you mean harden your heart? Yeah, every time you say no and God says do something, you're hardening your own heart. And making it even more, God has to do to soften you up. Amen, lights. He will do it, but he's not going to make you, but he can convince you that you need to do the right things. So if that's you, and you are not a Christian, you're not saved, and if you walk out here and a stray bullet hits you, or you get run over by a car, or any number of things that could happen to you in Philadelphia, amen, and you die and you haven't done that, you are going straight to hell. And we'll have a nice funeral for you and a memorial service and try to make up stuff that was good about you. We might even tell a lie or two just to help you out, but it ain't going to keep you out of hell. You go in there already the moment you leave here. And on your way to hell, you will bow at the feet of Jesus and say, Jesus, you are Lord. The problem is you waited too long because you're already on your way to hell. So if that's you, you need to surrender today. And if you do that, we put a chair up here. You know, at one point I'd put a chair up there for anybody in the door who needs to come forward in the door and give their life to Christ. Whether you are saved and you just need a church home, or you're unsaved but you want to surrender, and we'll pray with you the sinner's prayer, and you could ask Christ in, and then you can be part of his family, and you will receive the most valuable thing you can receive from him, which is the forgiveness of all of your sins. Because when he died, he paid that sin debt for you. And forgiveness is such a powerful thing. Oh, you can't even forgive somebody else until you understand that he forgave you first. So you need forgiveness, and he gives it. So we're going to give that invitation. We've got some music coming. We're going to play it up just a little bit more. I know you're hungry like me. It's a lot. It's salivating at the food, but those in the house. But we need to give people that opportunity, because if we don't give it to them, that's on us. But if we give you an opportunity to surrender and you don't, that's on you. And I can sleep at night because I know I did what I was supposed to do. So at this time, if that's you, come now. Give the preacher your hand, but give God your heart. you heard the message. So please, God is calling you now to add yourself to the family, to be a part of his vineyard. Surrender and give your life to him now. It's the best life you can ever give. So we'll just play a stanza so of that to give anyone the opportunity. If you're online, and last week alone we had 170 some people online with us for the first few days of the week, and you need to surrender and do it, you heard the message, just email or message or chat me and let me know you've done it. I get messages from people who watch our services, by the way. Just so you know, when y'all be clowning in here, I hear from them. Amen. Or when we are praising God, I hear from them. And so I'm here to tell them if they want to surrender, give your life to the Lord, do it right online, get a hold of me, I'll take care of it. I've got people who are saying, I want to commit tithes and offerings to you. If you want to do that, get a hold of me. We got people now who are starting to send us in our Cash App support to help us in this ministry. We need you to do that as well. Whatever the Lord is telling you, you need to say yes, because Reverend Glover can't do it by himself. Amen. Amen. That's what we heard today. I got to help him. He got to help me. We got to help each other. We're in this together. We're in this together. It's none of us is so great that we're so much greater than the other one. There's no respecter of person with God. You could come in here drunk as a skunk, fall in the door, and we have to pick you up. But God loves you as much as he loves anybody in the room. And it doesn't matter to him. He loves everybody. Amen. So we've done as the Holy Spirit has commanded, and yet there is room. Let's give God a hand. Now, Pastor Ward, God had to get the first hand, so I couldn't, can't give it to you. I'm sorry. Now, let's give Pastor Lindsay a hand, Lindsay Ward a hand. Girl, I don't know what took me so long to hear you preach. It won't be next time, I can tell you that. If y'all don't see me here, you was in pastor this week. I might be at St. Peter's. Amen. Amen. I love you. I love you. I love you, Pastor Ward. I love you. I love your spirit. I love your heart. I love the fact that you've surrendered so much, and I know a little bit of what you're dealing with even now, and I don't even know it all, but I know one thing, you are committed to Jesus Christ, and that much I do know. So at this time, I'm going to ask Reverend Glover if he would come and dismiss us, and Deacon Glover is in there getting the food ready with Martina, I assume, and so I want to thank all of you for coming. This is our third anniversary. Next week, we will be giving to our members something very special as a way of saying thank you for participating. Even those who are not here, we will be sending something. Those who have left us, to just say thank you for the time in which you spend here in this ministry. February for me was 51 years in ministry that I have been in ministry. And there has been no greater challenge to me as a minister than the last few years, because people just don't do church, amen, like they used to. It's like it's an inconvenience. And we were having a discussion at a Bible study, and they asked this young man to come to church. And he said, well, I can watch it online. And so the pastor was satisfied with the fact that he said, I can watch it. And I stopped everybody and said, oh, he said, I can watch it. He didn't say, I am watching it. He said, I can. So here's the thing, folks. You can watch it online, but you can watch it in person. So she told us that. You told us so much, sister.
Amen, amen.
I just thank God for you. So at this time, we're going to ask Reverend Glover if we'd all stand and be dismissed, however they have things arranged in the next room. Do that. You may not get overweight from what you're eating, but you will be hopefully full.
Amen, amen, amen. Did you enjoy that message? I know I did. Amen. I thank God for it. All right. Let us pray over the food first, and then we'll say the benediction and be dismissed. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we just thank you for the food, for the nourishment of our bodies, Lord God. May we use it for the building of your kingdom. We just thank you that we can commune with one another after church service, Lord, and give you honor and glory for it. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
And with that being said, all hearts and minds are clear. Amen. Let us be dismissed. Let's say the benediction. Let's look to the Lord. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to make you and present you standing in his presence with great joy and great glory, to the only wise God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. Let the church of God say amen, amen, amen. Amen. You're dismissed.